Hi there, this is Sophia from the Jane team. The next part of Jane we're going to look at is the charting area. Switching from paper to electronic can feel a bit scary for people, and we completely understand that it is a fairly big change. Our goal at Jane is that you're charting as quickly and as efficiently as possible. We know that practitioners don't love to chart, so we'd like to make that as easy on you as we can. Right now I'm logged into our demo clinic and I've signed in with practitioner Joellen McKay. When logging in as a practitioner, you're going to have your day view visible to you. So our day view showcases your upcoming appointments in the day. And if your clinic owner or account owner has turned on your practitioner dashboard, you'll also see some handy metrics at your fingertips as well. I won't go into too much detail about this now because we do have a great guide document that will thoroughly go through this, so feel free to review that one if you'd like to dig into this one a little bit deeper. I'm going to start off by clicking into an appointment that's upcoming in my day, and we're going to use Dylan as an example here. So when I click into an appointment for the first time, Jane is going to list all of the chart entries for this patient in chronological order with the date as well as the author of each of these charts. If the patient has seen multiple practitioners at the clinic, and if that practitioner has shared the privacy settings for their charts with another practitioner at the clinic, you will have the option to review the information in these charts. Of course, if that privacy sharing setting is turned off, then these are not going to be visible to you. I'm going to start off by showing you some of the options that we have in this top field here. If you're searching for a specific chart, you can look up a keyword in the search field to the top left, and Jane will pull up that chart accordingly. You'll also have the option of adding a medical alert for your patient. I've added in the word pacemaker here. We also often see practitioners use this field for social things too. It's important to note that anything written in this text box will not be included in the chart entries themselves. So if you were to export your charts and you require that this text be included, just make sure that you include this within the chart entry too. So you can be quite liberal with what you include in this field. Maybe Dylan went for a trip to Disneyland and you want to be reminded to ask him about that when he comes back. The other option here is to filter and then export your charts. If we select this, we'll be able to see our options for filtering. We can filter by specific disciplines, staff members, the state of the chart, and the date range where you'll be required to include a start date and an end date. We have a really excellent guide document that goes through all of the tools that Jane offers to build out your charts themselves. So I'm going to start off just by showing you some of those that will be available to you by clicking this little grid icon. So we have everything from a chief complaint to a note box, a sketch pad, the body chart. What I recommend here is when you log into our demo clinic, create a chart entry for yourself within one of our practitioners' day sheets like we've done here, and just get familiar with some of these charting tools so that you know what's available to you when you're building out your chart. When you do start a chart for the first time from your day view, you can select the new chart entry button. And Jane is going to show you some of the most commonly used tools that practitioners use, as well as the chart templates that you have to choose from as well. These may have been pulled from Jane's template library, or they may have been created by you from scratch within the chart templates area of your staff profile. So we're going to get to that in just a few minutes here, so hold tight for that. I'm going to create a new chart for Dylan here, and I'm just going to include some of these common tools that are used. So we have a chief complaint. You can now see that I'm using the drop-down menu from just below this chart entry, the Add Item button, If you'd like these to be showcased in a slightly different way, you can use the grid item where you'll see all of these tools listed as well, which we saw earlier. So I'm going to go ahead and add some of these items. We'll add some vitals here. These are all pre-established charting tools that Jane has offered that we've seen quite a bit of our practitioners use to build out their charts. The body chart is another extremely popular one. The reason being is that this is one of our more interactive charting tools. You can use the index tool to click numbers onto the body itself and then either type text into these boxes down below or dictate for faster charting. You can use the pencil feature to draw on your body as well. You can change the stroke size as well as the color too. And last but not least, you can change the image. So when you select change image, you can actually select any of the images that you have saved on your device and then open them here. If you need something like a table, which Jane currently doesn't offer as a charting tool, feel free to create a table in something like Word or Excel and then save that table as a JPEG or a, let's say a PNG. You can upload the table here and then draw on it. Which is something that we see clinics do from time to time. Now, I did mention that we were going to go into more detail about these chart templates here. And so let's head on over to our staff profile now. I'm going to select staff in the top blue bar and then click into chart templates. So our chart templates is home to all of our charts that we've customized and created on our own, as well as the templates that we've pulled from the template library. I'm not going to click into the template library because we do go into some more detail within this learning module. But what I do want to share with you is if you clicked into the template library, you'll have the option to search specific chart templates by discipline and then by order of popularity. We have, I believe, over 11,000 charts that have been shared into our template library. This is a peer-reviewed library of templates that other Jane members from our community have decided to share. And so we're quite proud of this, and it can be extremely handy and a big time saver when you're adding the charts from here. Let's pretend that we've added our physio assessment from the chart template library. Once you open it, you will have access to edit it directly. You can change the label as well as the default text that shows up in any of these text boxes. You can also change the title of this if you wish to do so. And then we can save it. Let's head on back over to our day view, where we're going to click back into Dylan's appointment. And now we're going to utilize our chart template to start charting for Dylan. I'm going to select physio assessment, and then you can start charting. Just like with any of our chart templates, you do have the option to delete certain sections if you need to after the fact. Now, this is only going to delete this item from this one unique chart entry. If you need to make any changes to your chart template that where that change is going to be for the chart moving forward as well, then you're going to want to do that from your staff tab and then chart templates here. So I hope this has been a helpful overview of Jane's charting basics. We go into a lot of detail in a number of our guide documents. So if you did want to search up guide within our guide library, you can do that. And I hope this was helpful. Of course, if you have any questions for us, please don't hesitate to reach out. Our email is support@janeapp.com. And I hope you have some fun charting.